Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you for clicking into this video. Today's video is, well, it was supposed to be a first impressions of all the stuff I bought during my last haul, but I made this video once before and the stupid audio didn't work, so I've used the items a couple of times now, so instead of a first impressions, I'm gonna be giving you guys like a mini review on all of these new products at Sephora. This is the look I came up with using all of these products. So if you guys wanna see how I got this look and all these new products in action, then please keep on watching. Okay, so we're gonna be working off the Soft Glam palette today. My brushes are dirty because this is the second time I'm doing this look. If you can't tell, I can't get over the fact that it took me so long to do that first video and now I have to do it again. But anyways, so this is what the palette looks like. It is freaking beautiful. The first color I'm gonna go into is Burnt Orange, and I'm just gonna mix it a little bit with orange soda just to dial it down a bit so it's not too strong. And I am going to put this right in my crease. So I'm just going in swiping motions like this, and then little circular motions to really help blend that color out. And then just kind of keep dipping in until you have a good fade and a good color. These shadows are so beautiful. They blend out almost with no effort. Like, you really don't need to do much to blend them out. Just let your brush do the work for you because they're just so blendable. They're so buttery. They're so pigmented. They do have a little bit of fall down when you use them, but that doesn't really bother me in palettes. As long as it blends nicely and doesn't stick down to one area, I'm fine if it has a little bit of fall down. This one is really nice. It's very, very cohesive. You can do a lot with it neutral, but you could still like do a lot of day to night looks with this. I just think it's really well thought out. Okay, next I'm gonna take a Smith 230, which is just a little bit smaller than the 232. And I'm gonna dip into Burnt Orange and Sienna. So this time I'm gonna go, I'm looking down into my mirror and finding my crease. And I'm gonna go right into the crease this time, just to deepen it up a bit. And I'm also gonna kind of circle it around this outer edge right here, and then going in, and then circling it around the inner edge. Now I'm gonna go back into that big brush, and I'm going to just blend those colors together. Okay, now I'm gonna take a Smith 247, and I'm gonna dip into the color Mulberry. Right here, this is like a beautiful, rich, reddish brown. I think this is one of my favorite colors in the palette. What I'm gonna do with that is pat it like this onto my outer corner. Just pat it in right now. Don't worry about blending or anything like that. Isn't that such a pretty color? I'm also gonna take that Mulberry color and we're gonna put it on the inner part of the eye. Okay, so now I'm gonna take that Smith 230 brush, so the one that was a little bit smaller than this one, and I'm gonna very, very lightly, barely touching my skin, I'm just gonna blend out these edges. Now do this really lightly just because you don't want to move that dark color where you don't want it. So if you blend really aggressively, you're just gonna make that color move to an area where you don't want it to be. Okay, so I'm gonna take a flat shader brush and I'm gonna dip into the color Sultry right here. This color is so pretty. And I am going to wet my brush with some Fix Plus. And I'm gonna put this in the center where we left the space empty. Okay, so I'm also gonna take a little bit of glistening right here, just on my finger. And I'm gonna put that right in the center. Just with my finger, right in the dead center of your eyeball. Okay, I'm gonna take this Marc Jacobs highlighter, gel crayon eyeliner in black, and I'm gonna tight line my eyes. Okay, now we'll go work on the face and then we'll come back to finish the eyes a little bit later. So like I was saying in the intro, since I have done this video before, I've been able to use a couple of the products now. So instead of a first impressions, it's gonna be more of a mini review since I know if I like these products or not. So for foundation today, I'm gonna use the Skin Feels Good Hydrating Skin Tint. Now this is not a, oh, and it has SPF in it too, if that's something you look for. Now this is not a foundation, this is a tint. So don't expect using this that you're gonna get medium to full coverage, that's not gonna happen. But it does have more coverage than say the Glossier Skin Tint or the Milk Makeup Sunshine Skin Tint. First Aid Beauty has one as well. This has more coverage than all of those, but it still is a tint. It's not gonna give you like full coverage, but it does such a beautiful job at just evening out your skin tone. I gotta say, I love it. So what I like to do is kinda throw it on my face. What I'll do is do half of my face first and then show you guys what it looks like. Now, one thing to note is that this does have quite a strong scent. So if you're very sensitive or sensitive to scent in general, you may not like this. I really like the scent. I think it's really nice, but it does worry me in a bit. It does worry me. Why am I having such a hard time talking? It worries me a bit because I am one of those people that have very, very sensitive skin. But I'm also someone that does not wear makeup every single day. I would just wear this sometimes. So I feel like if you were wearing it every single day, then just note that fragrance is like the fourth or fifth ingredient in this stuff. But God, it's so moisturizing. It literally feels like I'm putting on a very light daytime moisturizer. It gives me the SPF coverage that I want, and it doesn't settle into any of my fine lines. It doesn't settle into any of my dryness. It just looks so beautiful on the skin. So here's half my face done, and you can see it gave me a little bit of color. It evened out my skin tone, it covered my veins and my pigmentation, and it just makes me look healthy, but not like I'm wearing makeup. The makeup is almost like undetectable on the skin. Okay, so next we're gonna go into the Bare Minerals new concealer. This is their Bare Minerals Bare Pro 16 hour full coverage concealer. Now, this product really surprised me. I did not think I would like it because it's in a stick form, and products that come in a stick form like this tend to be very thick and waxy because you need a lot of wax in this product to keep its form of a stick. So these tend to be a lot heavier. So I thought it was gonna feel really heavy, feel really greasy, be hard to blend out. That was not the case. This blends out like, what's a good enough word? I don't know, but it blends out so nicely. I have dry under eyes. It does not accentuate my dryness. I have milia. It does not accentuate my milia. It's beautiful. You need to set this stuff. It will slip and slide around during the day if you don't set it, just because it is so creamy. See, it's definitely full coverage. Everything is covered, but you can barely see it on the skin. Okay, so without powdering, I will do a close-up right now just so you guys could see what my face looks like. So an item I have not used before is actually the Becca Hydra Mist Set and Perfect Powder. This is the one that's apparently made out of like 50% water and glycerin. So I was very, very intrigued. I am a broken record, but I have dry skin and I don't like to set my skin with powder because it just looks so bad. So I really wanted to try this out because everyone who's tried it says that it just melts into the skin. It doesn't look like you have powder on, which sounds amazing to me. And also, my base is very slippery slidey, so I definitely need something to set it. How the hell do you open this thing? Oh. So I can't get the damn sticker off this thing. Like, that's so annoying. So I'm just gonna pour a little bit onto the cap right here. It has like a peachy color to it. It feels very, very soft. I think I'm just gonna take it with my beauty blender and pounce it on my face. It's really weird. It does not feel like this is a powder. It feels like I'm putting on like some sort of wet something. Some sort of wet something. There you go. Okay, you guys, so I'm just gonna go ahead and say it. This powder looks like shit on my face. It made me look so pale, like I look ghostly, almost sick, and it just made everything look so powdery, but wet. Like wet in a powdery way. I don't know how to explain it, but it literally wrecked my whole base. Oh my god, it looks like shit on me. Let me see if I can do a close-up and show you guys what it looks like. I'm not sure if you guys can see it, but my skin looks so cakey and disgusting right now. It's just completely caked up, like on my nose, and it just, I don't know, like maybe I applied it you're not supposed to apply it with a beauty blender? I don't know. Okay, you guys, so I forgot to press record, so I'm just gonna fill you guys in on what I did. Let me grab the palette. So I took that eyeliner and I put it in my bottom waterline, and then I took a smudger brush and I took Mulberry and put it really close to my bottom lash line, and then I took like a small pencil brush and I just blended out Mulberry using a little bit of burnt orange, and then I applied Benefit Cosmetics Their Real Mascara, and I used a little bit of Tempera on my brow bone. And I don't have a new bronzer or blush to play with, so I just used an old bronzer and blush that I already had in my collection. And I'm so pissed off because this powder totally my makeup up. Like my makeup, it looks so bad. It clung to every single dry spot I have, and it took off all the makeup underneath my eyes. Like I just have patches of bald dry spaces under my eyes now. It looks really bad, which I'm so sad about because I really liked my base. But I think that this powder, maybe it's just not for me, or maybe I used it in the wrong way. Maybe I should use a brush instead of a beauty blender. Does anyone know? Can you let me know? Also, yes, I know I'm stupid, and I finally figured out the sifter thing. You just have to open it like that. Yeah, Okay, so let's finish up now. I have two highlights. I have this Amrezy one, and I have the new NARS highlight in Fort de France. Okay, so I think I'm gonna go in with the NARS highlight first, see how that looks, and then maybe I'll top it off with a little bit of the Amrezy one. We shall see. So I'm just gonna take this on my Anastasia A23 brush, really coat my brush in the product. And then I'm just gonna apply. I really like working highlight into the skin in like circular motions like this because I feel like the more you work it in, the more glossy it becomes and the more meshed into your skin. That's really pretty. It's subtle, but really pretty. So I'm gonna put that right here as well. It's actually really nice. It doesn't accentuate any texture, and I feel like this is a really good color for me. And like my products are not blending nicely on top of that powder. Let's try the Amrezy one for this step. Oh wow, that's a lot more pigmented than the other one. Ooh, that's pretty. Let's apply a little bit of this just right to the top right here. That's definitely a lot more intense. Okay, so I actually used a new product on my lips today as well. First, I went in with MAC Soar lip liner, and then I went on top with the Dior Lip Glow Color Reviver Balm. That is hard to say. That is hard to say. They have the lip, like the glossy formula, and now they came out with a matte formula as well, and I used the color 102. And even though my skin looks like complete shit right now, we have reached the end of the video. I hope you guys really enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to like and subscribe so that I could see all of you guys in the next video. Bye guys.